know that the Earth rotates, and the direction of that rotation is towards the east. So here I have a graphic of the Earth rotating. You can see every point is moving towards the east. That's the direction of rotation. And so the Earth has an axis that it rotates about. We would call that the Earth's rotational axis. And that's shown by this dotted line, dashed line here, and the arrow is showing the direction of rotation. Now, if we want to do astrophotography, we're on a rotating ball, so the stars are going to appear to move in the sky. So wherever we place our telescope on the surface, we need to understand how the stars move in the sky and do something about that. So I'm going to use stellarium to show what happens in the sky in terms of what we see from the Earth's surface. And here I'm looking to the north. If I superimpose this grid, then this centre focus here is straight up from a point here on the south coast of the UK. So I get rid of that grid. I'm just going to accelerate time. And by accelerating time, you start to see the sky is rotating. And that's obviously due to the Earth's rotation. And if I speed that rotation up, you can see it's rotating about a specific point. And if I make it go really fast, you can see there's actually a bright star that's pretty close to the point about which everything appears to be rotating. And so I'll just stop that there before we feel too sick. If I click on that star, you can see that that is Polaris. And that's why Polaris is so important to people in the Northern Hemisphere for doing astrophotography, because it's particularly useful for helping us to correct for the movement of the stars in the sky. If I zoom in a lot closer on Polaris and then once again accelerate time, you can see that Polaris is actually going round in a circle about a certain point. And if I switch on what's called the celestial poles, you can see it's drawn a point called NCP, that's North Celestial Pole. That is the point about which the whole sky appears to rotate in the northern hemisphere. Now similarly, stop that, if I zoom out and put the grid back on, that's looking straight up. It also looks straight down towards the south if we were in Australia, for example, and look straight down. And do the same thing, accelerate time, and you'll see that there is a point about which everything, I'll pull it across a little bit actually, just pull that over, and accelerate time, and you can see that everything is rotating about another point called the South Celestial Pole. Unfortunately for astronomers in the Southern Hemisphere, there is not a particularly bright star close to the South Celestial Pole. And so they have to use patterns of stars. In fact, they use these four here predominantly to assist with dealing with this rotation. So it's not quite as convenient as it is for people in the Northern Hemisphere. So what do we have to do to deal with this rotation? So coming back to this diagram, considering where our telescope is mounted, what we need to do is apply a rotation to the mounting of our telescope about an axis which is exactly parallel to the Earth's rotational axis, and the rotation needs to be applied to rotate the sky back in the opposite direction, or if you like, to follow the stars as they rotate, so that rotation is effectively taken out, and therefore we can do very long exposures on faint objects in space. And that process of aligning that axis is called polar alignment, and is generally applied on what's called a German equatorial mount, which have two axes, one called the right ascension and the other one called the declination, and those axes are organized so that the right ascension axis is the one that is parallel to the Earth's rotational axis, and the declination axis is simply at right angles to that, to give us that other degree of freedom for pointing at different things in the sky. So it's all about getting that right ascension, or RA axis, parallel to the Earth's rotational axis, and that's done with the aid of the stars, and in the Northern Hemisphere here, with the aid of Polaris. So what I'm going to do next is to show you the actual process of polar aligning a German equatorial mount. So here's an example of a German equatorial mount. In this case, it's an iOptron Skyguider Pro. And essentially comprises of a piece of hardware that sits in between the tripod and the camera. And the key things to point out, firstly, is the right ascension axis, which you see here. That's the axis that needs to be aligned to be parallel with the Earth's rotational axis. We have the declination axis, which is at right angles to the right ascension. Then we have this altitude azimuth bracket. Now, the purpose of the altitude azimuth bracket is to allow us to make those adjustments to get the right ascension axis parallel to the Earth's rotation axis. And that's done using two different adjustments. One is in azimuth. These two opposing screws here rotate the base of the azimuth bracket in a horizontal plane, and then the altitude or elevation adjustment screw adjusts in elevation. So those are the adjusters at the bottom which enable us to align that right ascension axis. Now, to assist us with knowing where to point it, where to point the right ascension axis, a lot of these mounts actually embed a small telescope inside the mount, and this is no exception. The iOptron Skyguider Pro has what's called a polaroscope inside the body of the mount. This is the lens cap, and this is the cap over the eyepiece. So you pull out remove those two items, and you can look through there. There's an illuminated graticule, and it has rings on it, which I'll show in a second, which enable you to, using some software, to determine where Polaris should sit on those rings at a given time of day from a particular point on the Earth. And by doing so, the actual axis of the mount is then aligned to the North Celestial Pole. So this is what the graticule looks like in the polaroscope eyepiece of the Skyguider Pro, and essentially a set of concentric rings and a crosshair in the middle. And what we need to do is to use an app. I use an app called Polaroscope Align Pro on my phone, which tells me for a given location, date and time where Polaris should be for the right ascension axis of the mount to be pointing at the North Celestial Pole. And you can see here this cross is showing where Polaris needs to be at 20:14 and 40 seconds on the 24th of July 2020 from my location. So to set it up, we set up the tripod and attach the Altaz bracket to the top, making sure it's nice and tight, and then rotate the tripod base so that the slope of the mount on the bracket at the top is pointing roughly due north. Then you just fine adjust the legs of the tripod so that the spirit level bubble shows that we're level, and then set up the altitude angle to match our latitude, in my case 51 degrees, and then lock that off. So with the base of the Altaz bracket level and this sloping bracket pointing due north, we should be good enough that when we mount the main body of the tracker and look through the polaroscope, we can see Polaris in the graticule. So we now add the balance bar and our camera. Securing that, just check our balance, and we're ready now to complete the polar align by looking up through the reticule, taking out the lens cap and the eyepiece cover. So the process that you follow, you look through the eyepiece, you see the graticule, and you see Polaris, and I've represented Polaris with this white circle. So let's assume you get roughly close to it and you get Polaris in sight. And what's the process that you follow? Well, the first step is to adjust both the altitude and azimuth bulbs in order to move Polaris to the central cross point of the polaroscope. Then what we do is, using the altitude bolt only, is to lift Polaris up until it's on these inner rings. And once it's on the inner rings, we then rotate the RA of the mount so that the 12 o'clock point, this point here, comes round and coincides with where Polaris is. So there's the, after the rotation, we've now got Polaris at the top of the 12 o'clock. So we've now got, that's ensuring that this line here is vertical and aligned with the elevation axis. So now we then refer to the app. We see where Polaris needs to be. In this case, it's not actually a big move from where it already is, but it could be anywhere around the circle. And we make adjustments to the altitude and azimuth bolts to move Polaris into the correct position. And once that's done, we are polar aligned. And so long as we don't disturb or jog the mount, we're good to go, and we will be able to track the stars. So sorry about all the complicated theory. Hope it wasn't too complicated, but I wanted to do a slightly different video to other people to actually explain what's going on, rather than just how to do it, what's behind it, and how it works. And I hope that you found it interesting, and hopefully at the end there you can see it's not actually too difficult a process. So thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, please like, share, and subscribe. See you next time.